Welcome to the Crew Show. How was everyone's first day? Good. Wonderful.
So, all right, so these crew leaders have been working on the show for 2 weeks. They've been sweating, they've been bleeding, they've been dancing their heart out, so they're super excited for this crew show. You guys excited?
So before we go, we really just want to do this thing that we like have always wanted to do, and that's kind of why we took this job. No, just totally kidding. So can we get a crew check? All right, it was close, it was fine. All right. It's fine.
Take two.
One more time. All right, ready? Can I get a crew check? There it is.
C-A-U-A.
All right, we're gonna leave it to them now. Bye.
Oh my God.
Bobby Johnson beat. You're now listening to a Bobby Johnson beat.
Panda. I got broads in Atlanta. She's with the V in the family. Credit cards in the scammers. Hitting the licks in the valley. Legacies, family. Wait and see, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana. Honey killers on the helmets. Legacies, family. Wait and see, panda. Pockets full, Danny. Selling ball, candy. Man, I'm the macho like Randy. The chopper go out to for granted. This nigga bullet, you bandit. Hope you killers understand it.
Soldier boy, tough. Hey, I got this new damn for y'all called the Soldier Boy. Just gotta punch, then crank back 3 times from left to right.
Stop, don't talk to me. Loser, lame, I wanna be like, oh, totally.
You on my mind, your secret admirer. I've been watching.
Fun, 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 fun.
Everybody get up, it's time to slam now. We got a real jam going down. Welcome to the Space Jam. Space Jam. It's your chance, do your dance at the Space Jam. Alright.
Jacobson.
When the sun goes down, ain't no finer girl in town. You're my girl, what the doctor ordered. So sweet, you make my mouth water.
Ooh, I want candy. I want candy.
Crew 7, Elliot Sled.
In the crib, ma. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. When the pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot. Park it like it's hot.
Crew 9, Cassidy Machowski.
I need somebody to lean on.
Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you.
Nothing. There's a way to I get through. Big on the man, my man, jump on. And you know my man.
Gonna spread my wings. It's my chance to shine. Michael Bose.
Please use discretion when you're messing with the message, man. These lyrics aren't for everyone, only if you understand.
Crew 19, Kenneth Kidd.
Take me away. Do you have everything you need?
Yep, I've got everything I need. I'm so ready to go.
Man, I love college. Let's go.
We're finally here. I'm so excited.
I'm so happy.
Well, it looks like you have everything you need.
Do you have my first aid kit, my band-aids, my backup inhaler? What about my favorite picture of mittens?
How are we gonna do this, guys? What are we gonna do?
I don't
know.
All right, it's time for us to go now.
You're my boy, Blue.
We just wanted to give you this last second.
Ew.
Well, we just wanted to.
Ew.
But.
Ew.
Ladies, what does Dad not get about ew?
Hello. My name is Kenneth Tribble. Kenneth Kidd. I am the aspiring president of Christopher Newport University. And 20 years ago, we set out to build another great university for America. Our purpose was to make CNU one of America's preeminent public liberal arts universities. And you know what? With the help from a lot of wonderful people, we're there. This is why, during our performance, we will periodically step out of character and tell you what it means to be a captain to each of us. A captain is significant. Here at Christopher Newport, it's all about finding one's purpose. And with the Student Assembly, the President's Leadership Program, and making meaningful relationships with faculty and staff members, I was able to define my significance on this campus. Through the Student Assembly, I was able to listen to my peers and make a difference. And by making meaningful connections with faculty and staff members, I've had relationships and opportunities I otherwise would have missed. So get out there, get involved, make those connections, and remember to lead, serve, love, and set the world on fire. A captain is significant.
A captain is encouraging. My freshman year, I was terrified. I built a wall around myself and no one was allowed in. My RA encouraged me to take a risk. So I joined a faith-based organization. I'm on the orientation team, and I applied to be a freshman RA so that I can have the same effect on someone that she had on me. Since then, my experience at Christopher Newport has changed dramatically, and it's all thanks to one unexpected friend, my RA. A captain is encouraging.
A captain is intentional. Coming into my freshman year at CNU, I thought I wanted to join pretty much every single club and organization that Club Fair had to offer, and even hold leadership positions within all of them. However, throughout my collegiate career, I soon realized that it's so important to invest my time and things that help me reach my goals, further my career, and make me happy. A captain is intentional.
A captain is always growing. During my junior year, I decided to try something new and got involved with Special Olympics soccer as a coach. I have absolutely zero athletic ability, so it took a lot of work to push me past my awkwardness and discomfort. My athletes have taught me so much about how to treat others, which has made me a better member of the CNU community. A captain is always growing.
A captain is admirable. This past semester at CNU, I became very ill, not sure if I would be able to continue taking classes here because of my health. I, of course, have gotten much better since, but I wouldn't be able to say that if it wasn't for the help of my fellow captains and CNU community. For example, my professors would approach me after class on some of my worst days, noticing me and asking me if I was all right. When a professor that you admire looks you in the eyes and tells you why you will be successful and how they'll do anything they can to help you get to that success, you realize, among many reasons, why this university was one of the greatest things to ever happen to you. A captain is admirable.
A captain is bold, because CNU pushes you to both challenge your limits and be your authentic self. For me, it meant coming out to the unwavering support of my friends and sisters. It means having a community that tenaciously encourages me to get on a plane by myself for the first time, fly across the ocean, and study in a foreign country for 5 months. But no matter how far I wander or how much I grow, I know that CNU will always be a safe harbor to come home to. A captain is bold.
So with that, congratulations on being members of Christopher Newport's class of 2020. I will be narrating the Crew Leaders production of College from the Inside Out. We will focus on four stellar incoming freshmen as they embark on their new journey: Katie, Ethan, Kristen, and Michael. These four students represent four different emotions that students may have as they begin their collegiate careers here in Newport News. Some students, like Katie, are extremely excited to begin their new journey here at Christopher Newport. For our purposes, the emotion joy will be represented by the color yellow.
Come on, we're finally here. Come on, I finally get to move into CNU.
Honey, wait, I haven't even kissed you goodbye
yet. Come on, hi, I'm Katie.
Hi, welcome to your work.
Oh, thanks, I'm so excited.
Here, you will see the joyful emotions of Katie. We will step into Katie's head so that her emotions can give us an inside look into what she is thinking. Our next student, Ethan, is not looking forward to certain aspects of college life, like sharing another room with another person. Sometimes, a student may be disgusted by the disturbances in their daily life. Disgust is represented by the color green.
Do I really have to live in a dorm? I've never had to share a room with someone.
Son, remember what the tour guide said. They're not dorms, they're residence halls.
Whatever.
Don't you backsass me.
Hi. Hi, welcome to York.
Thanks.
Here is where Ethan's emotions will be located. Starting a new chapter of one's life is intimidating, and students like Kristen are frightened by the unknowns. Fear is represented by the color purple.
Moms, I really don't know about this. I heard the coursework is really rigorous. What if a meteor hits and where's my nasal spray?
Sweetie, it'll be okay, and you packed it in your backpack.
Whew, you're right.
Remember, when you get worried, you can always call us on our cell phone.
Totally right.
Hi.
Hi, welcome to York.
Thanks.
Kristen's emotions of fear will live over here, next to Ethan's emotions of disgust. Leaving behind family and friends can be hard for some students, and Michael is certainly no exception. The emotion sadness is represented by the color blue.
Hi, welcome to York.
Hi.
Sorry about our son.
Michael's emotions of sadness will be located over there to Katie's, next to Katie's emotions of joy.
Hi, I'm Erin.
I'm Caitlin.
I'm also Erin, and we are your freshman RAs this year.
We have your student IDs right here.
We have lots to show you about campus.
Welcome to our house.
Haven't done this before, so
more we live. CNU's got much to give. Sometimes you gotta explore, yeah. Welcome to our house. You can take control now. Go down to the Nolan. We don't have to go far. Welcome to our house. Need a place to go now. Take a trip by Jefferson and make some new memories. Explore Newport News. Explore Newport News. He comes and you know that you gotta swim. Grab your friends, it's time to catch some waves. Huntington, Buck Grove, or Virginia Beach. Let's go all day, come on, celebrate. Sometimes you gotta stay in. Do you know where we live? CNU's got much to give. Sometimes you gotta explore, yeah. Welcome to our house. You can take control now. Go down to the cookout. We don't have to go far. Welcome to our house. Need a place to go now. Take a trip to read us and make some new memories. Explore Newport News.
Welcome to the 757, the spot, the campus. But my house is your house if you throw on the crew check. I'm sorry if my home is bringing the stress, but soon these happy faces are gonna turn into friends.
Home run, slam dunk, touchdown pass. Mi casa es tu casa, captains don't hold back. Another Einstein's coffee, you know what's in my mug. It's our house, just relax.
Welcome to our house. You can take control now. Go down to the Nolan. We don't have to go far. Welcome to our house. Need a place to go now. Take a trip by Jefferson and make some new memories. Explore Newport News. Explore Newport News.
Welcome to your house. A captain is inclusive. I was really close with my freshman year roommate, and after she decided to transfer halfway through the year, I found myself in need of searching for new friendships. That isn't always an easy thing to do, but luckily I had a hall filled with amazing people that welcomed me with open arms, and I will forever be thankful that a captain is inclusive.
A captain is a teammate on and off the field. This past February, I had to get hip surgery, which made me miss my entire junior year lacrosse season. I was afraid of all the repercussions this would have in my life. Would I be able to play lacrosse again? Could I continue my leadership position in my sorority? All of these fears were overcome when my sisters and teammates stepped up to support me in ways I never knew I needed. And that's when I realized a captain is a teammate on and off the field.
A captain is goofy. As I sat at graduation this year and watched friends just a year above me walk across the stage, I thought back to my best moments here at CNU. Whether those were shopping cart races through Walmart, spontaneously attending a Greek festival and dancing on stage with them all night, or just singing Frozen as loud as I can to friends walking by with other friends on my hall. We never took ourselves too seriously. As you make this transition from high school to college, there are gonna be things you wanna leave behind, and that's great. Part of the beauty of college is that it's a fresh start. It's a chance to hit a reset button. But don't leave behind your quirks, craziness, or weird sense of humor. Never sacrifice who you are for the sake of being cool or trying to be popular. A captain's goofy.
A captain is brave. Entering college just a year ago, I knew I was going to have to try new things, and I was terrified, even with the constant support of my friends, family, and boyfriend. However, all it took was 20 seconds of courage to introduce myself to someone new, whether that be a professor or someone on my hall. In addition, that courage helped me to submit applications, which led me on stage in front of you today among the sense of community that made me fall in love with this school. That courage made the world of difference. A captain is brave. A captain is impactful. CNU had always been my dream school, and after applying and finding out that I had been waitlisted, I was devastated. I felt I would be insignificant and contribute very little to the CNU community. Little did I know, I would be a big for Big Brothers Big Sisters, the head RA in one of our resident buildings, and now an orientation leader for the class of 2020, all thanks to the very inspiring and encouraging individuals here on campus. A captain is impactful.
Few schools have come so far so quickly. We built a beautiful campus. We have extraordinary students, a world-class faculty, and with expanding reach and reputation, we have become a university for the ages. The quality that distinguishes us from virtually every other school in the nation is that we believe it is our job to shape hearts and minds. We believe that real success is a life well lived, a life of significance, a life of meaning, consequence, and purpose. With that, student involvement has become key to our purpose. Furthermore, Club Fair is an exciting and hectic time here at Christopher Newport. The Office of Student Activities hosts this event in the Freeman Fieldhouse, and it is a great opportunity for captains to find their significance.
There is literally nothing to do at this school.
Our friends aren't here, and I'm sorry, but our roommate is so smelly.
You guys are so right, but at least our Vineyard Gucci Bedazzled Jordans are lit.
There's nothing to do at this school.
I'm sure we can find something for you to do, Ethan.
Whoa, Club Fair, Club Fair, Club Fair, Club Fair!
Oh my gosh, you know what we can suggest?
Club Fair. Maybe
we can go to the Nolan.
Club Fair.
Or, oh gosh, what else makes us happy? We can go to the beach.
Club Fair.
Wait, I know what we can do.
What? Club Fair.
We can go to the Club Fair.
Woo!
Oh my gosh, what a great idea. We should totally do that.
I'm gonna push it.
Okay, let's go.
I know, we can go to the Club Fair. It's right here in the Freeman, and all of the clubs and organizations on campus will be there. There's gotta be something you wanna do. Come on.
Ugh, whatever, let's just go.
Okay, fine. Hey, welcome.
Hi, it's
Hi
nice
I'm Katie.
To meet.
How's it going? Are you guys freshmen?
Yeah. So actually, as a freshman, getting involved in Greek life here at CNU is a huge responsibility, both financially and as a time commitment. CNU requires you to establish yourself with academically and within the community here at CNU before making that big decision.
Yeah, that's by no means meant to scare you. It's just CNU recognizes 18 different fraternities and sororities on this campus. It's quite the undertaking to get to know all of them in just your first week here. Without further ado, we might as well introduce ourselves. Boys, we are Alpha Beta Gamma, Delta Epsilon Zeta Eta Theta Iota Kappa Lambda Mu Nu Xi Omicron Pyro Sigma Tau Epsilon Phi Chi Omega Fraternity.
Ooh. And we were established 1738 BCE as one of the premier Greek organizations.
Absolutely not.
That's quite a name you got there, guys. Cool.
Not them? No?
No.
Okay.
Hey, what's up? We're intramural basketball. Undefeated champions.
Hey, what's up? Hello. Hey.
If you want to win, you gotta join us.
Zero losses.
Where can I sign up?
Ew, not them either. They seriously smell, you guys.
I'm sorry, are they sweating?
Ew!
No. No, thank you. No, thank you.
See you on the court.
No, yeah, you won't.
I mean, I guess they were a little intimidating.
Knock, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Res Life. Are you guys interested in joining Residence Hall Association?
We have a tie-dyeing event next week if you want to come out and join. Dude, I'll totally be there.
OMG, ladies, they might have some free t-shirts. And they're almost as cute as we are.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll see you there.
Cool.
They seem nice.
Hey, we're the green team.
Hey, what do you guys do?
Well, we work to promote economic and social sustainability through an environmental lens here at CNU.
And did you know, as an extension of our club, at the end of each day, we go around to all the dining halls and we take the unused food and we donate it.
Would you like to try some of our snacks? They're non-GMO, gluten-free, dairy-free, cruelty-free, vegan, vegetarian, pescatarian, sustainably produced, paleo, and local.
Green is our favorite color.
You're so right. OMG, this one.
Ladies, I think we found the club for Ethan.
I think so.
Yeah, sign me up.
Great.
Also, you all should follow me on Instagram.
Oh, what's your handle?
At Ethan Hovanic.
Bye, Ethan. Have fun with Green Team.
See you, Katie.
As you begin your collegiate career, look deep into your hearts and souls. This is a time to decide, who am I? Who will I become? Why was it that I was created? So dream boldly. Have a great vision for your life. Remember, we are here to change the world. There's a magic at CNU. People speak and smile, and you feel the energy, the enthusiasm, the forward motion, the expectation for success. No matter where you find yourself becoming involved on this beautiful campus, you can be sure that you'll be feeling CNU in no time.
Tonight, tonight, when you hold it.
A captain is confident. In high school, I never had trouble talking to people or putting myself in new situations. But when I got to CNU, I realized that had changed. After a few months here, I realized I started to feel really lonely and unsure of myself, which was something I wasn't used to. After a while, I realized I needed to feel more connected to our campus, and that probably meant talking to people that weren't from my high school. I decided to join a couple of organizations in hopes of meeting new people. Little did I know I would gain much more than that. The people on this campus have helped me find myself and be the person I've always wanted to be. They have pushed me to conquer fears that I never thought I would be able to do before. Because of my fellow captains and the confidence they have instilled in me, I know I can conquer whatever my future holds. A captain is confident.
A captain is at home. A year ago, I was you. I'd gone through a long day of awkward social encounters, desperately trying to find a friend and find my place here. See, I wanted to go to school somewhere else. So when I came to setting sail, I was afraid that because seeing you wasn't my top choice, or even in my top five, that I wasn't gonna love it here. I couldn't have been more wrong. Within weeks of being here, I got involved. I joined Marching Man, I joined a faith-based organization, and I met some amazing people that really made me feel welcomed. I had become a captain, and even though seeing you wasn't my first choice, it was my best choice. A captain's at home.
A captain is always a captain. Following my sophomore year, I took a year off of school, moved across the country, and was unsure of my return to CNU. Although 3,000 miles stood between myself and the CNU community, when I returned, I was welcomed back with open arms. This reassured me that a captain is always a captain.
A captain is fearless. Through times of difficulty and uncertainty, a captain is able to face these moments fearlessly. Coming into my freshman year, I was very closed-minded and reserved. I feared not making any connections, not making an impact on campus, and not leaving my mark. By being vulnerable with my peers, I was able to make connections that will last a lifetime and have made CNU my home away from home. A captain is fearless.
A captain is selfless. While in college, you'll encounter several roadblocks, whether it's relationships, academics, or for me, personal health. With just a couple of weeks left of my last semester as a sophomore, I was hospitalized with internal stomach damage. My roommate dropped everything he was doing to take me to the hospital. With my family being out of state, it would take them 7 hours to get here before they could see me. One of my fraternity brothers stayed with me the entire time. While I was unable to talk to them, he got them to the hospital and reunited me with my family. This is brotherhood. This is CNU. A captain is selfless.
When you ask people for their very best, they will astound you with their success. We were put on this planet to make a difference, and the world desperately needs more people like you. We couldn't be more happy to welcome you to this magical place. And as the bell tower chimes to ring in the first day of classes at our young and vibrant university, there are countless emotions filling the air. From students to professors, everyone can approach the day in a different light. On the first day in the McMurrin Hall, the students locate the classroom that will hold the first course of their collegiate careers. You will see the professor begin the semester with a description of their class's syllabus, which outlines what the class will be doing in the upcoming weeks.
Good morning and welcome to Early American to Civil War History. Now,
I'm in the wrong class.
Does anyone else need to exit? All right, well, if you notice, I went and handed out your syllabus. Now, this is going to include all the important information you need for this upcoming semester, including due dates of tests, which if you notice, there's one coming up in a couple weeks, as well as due dates for papers, projects, quizzes, and anything else you might need to know assignment-wise. Also, there's information on the grading scale, as well as my contact information and my office hours. Now, I hold office hours every Monday and Wednesday in McMurrin, so feel free to come stop by and ask any questions you may have. But if you come and ask a question that is answered in the syllabus, I will just tell you to read the syllabus. So make sure you read it all the way through. Now, I know that it's syllabus week, but we're going to go ahead and start our first lecture anyway. So take out your notebooks, and we'll start with Native American history.
As the 50-minute course comes to a conclusion, everyone is feeling nervous about the upcoming assignments and workload that they will be facing.
I don't know, this seems like a lot.
Are we in the right classroom? I thought there'd be more people here.
I don't know, but thank goodness for small class sizes. Less people to embarrass ourselves in front of.
No. There are 19 people in this class. That's 18 other people that will never talk to us again.
No. That's not the real problem. The real problem is this syllabus is longer than any book I ever read in high school.
There's no way I can do all of this. Our professor is not as cute as we thought she'd be.
And like, okay, what if all this note-taking ruins our manicure?
OMG, guys. I think our professor is sweating.
Oh, ew.
I hate studying.
Everyone looks so much more prepared for this class than we are.
And the syllabus looks so confusing. I don't even know if we can find her office.
Guys, I don't know if we're gonna be able to do this.
No.
Okay, guys, not gonna lie. This class looks a little challenging, but remember, we passed the Center for Academic Success earlier. And I bet they'll be able to help us study.
With all the tutors in it, and they are so helpful.
Wait a minute, hold on, okay. Why is Katie so happy? Jesus. Going down. Okay, I have a note here from Pete Carlson. He said, we had 24 friends on our hall automatically, and that made a...
It's called a learning community.
Learning community, that's what it is.
And they'll be so great for study group.
Whoa, joy!
Oh my gosh, I can't wait.
All right, let's go, here we go.
Huh. This class is a little more challenging than anything I've done before. But if my learning community makes a study group, there's no way we can do bad.
Katie, being an astute captain, is correct. There are various forms of academic resources that you can all use to ensure your success on this campus.
Excuse me? This class gets out at 10:50 and it's only 10:49. And please don't pack up while I'm still lecturing. All right, class dismissed. See you next week.
To stay on top of their academic workload, many students form study groups with their friends to help ensure their success in the classroom. How about we check up on some study groups as they prepare for their final exams?
Algorithms?
There's a hole in your leggings.
Okay. A plus 2 squared equals B.
No.
Okay, all right, guys. We can go to our professor's office hours, and they'll help us out. Come on.
And tendu, rond de jambe, and plié.
Why do we have to take this class again?
Everyone has to take in our class. It's part of the liberal learning curriculum. Now, let's go on point.
I just don't know any of this.
You know who would know this? Michael. Have you guys seen him?
No.
Our roommate is still so smelly.
Oh, you're right. Ethan, have you seen Michael?
No, I actually haven't seen him all day.
Well, he could really help us with this. I'm gonna go find him.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Being away from loved ones for an extended period of time can be a problem that some students have never had to face before. Luckily, home is just a phone call away.
We miss Mom and Dad so much. I'm so homesick.
Oh, no. Is she coming over here? What do we do?
Oh, guys, everyone just act normal.
Okay, good.
Hey, Michael, we missed you studying with us. What are you up to?
Okay, he looks a little blue. Yikes. What do we do?
It's okay, we can fix this. What does everybody love? Oh, we can just make him smile. Okay, guys, let's show him our...
shiny teeth that sparkle just like the stars in space. Wow, that put a smile on my face. But you know what else made us happy? Mom and Dad, right?
Oh, right, yeah.
Absolutely, yeah. Yes.
Maybe we should suggest that.
We'll tell her. We'll tell her. Yeah. Okay.
How are you doing?
Oh, not too good. I really miss
Well, you know, when I really missed home the first week we were here, I went to see the counseling center, and they really helped me talk through all my homesickness and made the whole college transition so much easier. And then, you know, last week I was feeling down again because I had gotten a bad grade on a test and called my mom to talk it through, and she made me feel so much better. Apparently, a B is not a bad grade anymore.
That's a good idea. I really miss them, so I'm gonna give them a call.
Great, and then come study with us. We really need your help.
All right, I'll see you then.
See you there.
Meanwhile, at Michael's house.
You used to call me on my... You used to. Yup. You used to call me on my cell phone, late night when you eat my buns. Call me on my cell phone, you know I'll help you out of the love. And I know when my cell phone rings, it can only mean one thing. I know when my cell phone rings, my child needs bubbling to ting.
Ever since I left the city, you got a reputation with the neighbors now. Mom, their sons can't be yours too, that's not allowed. Dad, I missed your call, sorry, I'm stressed out. Cause ever since I left the city, you started wearing sweats and studying more. It's okay, I love you, son, just call more. Let us know you get good grades and test scores. Okay, I'll call you on my cell phone. All right, guys, thanks so much for talking to me. I really miss you a lot.
Yeah, I miss you too. Hey, Michael, I know finals can be a stressful time and everything, but when you were back home, I remember you loved to go out and shoot some hoops. Do you have any way of going out and, you know, relieving some stress when you're there?
You know, that's an awesome idea. I should totally make an intramural team.
Yeah, that sounds like a great idea. Well, I gotta go, son. I love you. You have a good day.
I love you too, Dad. Talk to you later.
All right, bye.
Well, glad you could make it. Any chance you know how to do this problem?
Yeah, I actually know how to do this one.
See, you know so much more than you thought you did.
There's just so much studying to be done. How can we do all of it? It just seems impossible.
Guys, I know we're all super stressed right now, but my parents gave me a great idea. What if we started an intramural team?
Well, I guess it can't be as scary as this test.
I'm game.
Come on, let's go.
Introducing Flower Power!
Triple them gum
will make you smile.
Triple them gum,
it lasts a while.
Triple them gum
will help you, mister, to punch that breath right in the kisser.
Triple them gum!
Introducing Mix Nuts!
Here comes the
y'all don't really want it like that, yeah.
Man, we are really smelly.
Oh, gosh. Well, Now that that game is over, this test doesn't seem nearly as intimidating. Let's get down to business.
Captain is accepting. As a member of the LGBT community, I was nervous to come to Christopher Newport because I was afraid I wouldn't find a supportive community, let alone any kind of love life. In fact, one of the first times I came to CNU, an androgynous individual approached me and said, because I had so clearly set off her gaydar, and told me if I was looking for love, I came to the wrong place. Little did she know I was visiting my girlfriend at the time, who was a freshman here, but regardless of my relationship status at the time, it was a nerve-wracking statement to hear. I thought maybe CNU wasn't the place for me. However, I'm happy to say that that individual couldn't have been more wrong. Here at CNU, I've been able to find an incredible LGBT community that I can now call family. I've been able to find incredibly supportive allies, 24 who are actually up here on stage with me, who have been able to help me through some of life's toughest challenges and support me through everything. So to those of you who are members of the LGBT community, CNU might not seem like the right place for you right off the bat, but if you give it some time and you look around, you'll find that a captain is accepting.
A captain serves. When I came in my freshman year, I knew that I wanted to get involved in community service as much as possible. I didn't know where to start, though, so I went up to my freshman RA, and she introduced me to a fall weekend-long camp for children with emotional needs. I decided to pack up and go, and I fell in love immediately. What I didn't know, though, was if I were to commit to this camp for the next 4 years, I would also be missing every one of my sorority's semi-formal dances. I decided to commit to it, though, and I know that I made the most perfect choice possible, because although I did miss dressing up with my sorority sisters, I've also made memories that will last a lifetime, and I know that I've made a lasting impact on the Newport News community. A captain serves.
A captain is driven. I'll be honest, CNU was my first choice as a school, but I didn't let that change my attitude when I got here. But come first semester, I struggled studying, preparing for my exams, and my grades suffered. But as second semester came around, I really found that I had an entire community of captains around me to help me reach my goals and succeed. By putting in the extra hours with my professors during their office hours and forming good study groups, I was able to pull my GPA up to a much higher level. Captain is driven.
A captain is involved. In my first semester at CNU, I knew I wanted to get involved on campus, but I had no clue what I wanted to do. I remember feeling overwhelmed at club fair by all the activities, so I pretty much signed up for everyone. Eventually, I was able to narrow my involvement down to a few activities I was really passionate about. Here at CNU, there's a strong mindset that the more you put into something, the more you'll get out of it. I encourage you all to find those activities that you're passionate about, get involved, and share in the CNU mindset. A captain is involved.
A captain is resilient. Coming to college is a unique and challenging experience. Like many of you, I came and I was away from home for the first time. I was ambitious. I wanted to get involved in everything. I wanted to do everything a college student generally would do. Little did I know, over the next 3 years, I would be faced with every challenge and every mistake at the same time. For the longest time, I allowed my mistakes to hold me down. It wasn't the character that I wanted to be portraying, and it wasn't the things that I wanted to be doing. It wasn't until I made one of the biggest mistakes in my life that I realized it's not about the mistakes you make, but how you respond in the midst of adversity that defines your character. Rebound. Make a better you. Here at CNU, we support a community that's a helping hand to help you up no matter how hard you fall. Let your biggest downs become your biggest ups. A captain is resilient.
You will discover that these next 4 years of your life will be defining for you, and that they are the most important years of your life. This fact alone underscores the significance of final exams. After countless hours of studying, reading, and collaborating with professors, the end of the semester has arrived. Let's wish our fellow captains Godspeed as they tackle their final exams.
Georgia!
Okay, class, I know it's the final exam. I'm gonna need you to take a deep breath.
Ew.
Go ahead and collect your emotions. Now please take out your Scantrons. Take out your Scantrons. You have an hour to finish the final exam. Good luck.
Ew, why is everybody freaking?
freaking out? I don't know, this test is going to be so easy, and we're still so cute.
Honestly though, does anyone else smell how smelly our roommate is? Oh,
yes, yes. Okay, low-key, looking at this test, so glad that we got a tutor and we studied with our learning communities. Y'all, we got this.
Oh yeah.
The answer to this one, we studied it, is A.
Well, I mean, there's no J for joy, so it's gotta be A then, right?
Yeah, A for A's this test.
Joy! Here we go.
Guys, how do we even fill in the Scantron? What's the difference between class and self?
Oh, no. You know what we forgot?
What?
Our lucky number 2 pencil!
No, none of this is gonna be right!
Yes?
Can I, go to the bathroom?
Yeah, we have an honor code. You're an adult and you no longer have to ask.
Guys, we got 3 C's in a row. Something must be wrong.
What if I'm actually dumb and nobody just ever told me? Because I don't know any of this!
What if they make us play Ride That Pony later?
An angry raccoon?
No, guys, focus. Remember, the only thing to fear is fear itself.
Honestly, our dog is probably smarter than these people.
You're right. OMG, has nobody ever heard of Dress Well, Test Well?
Obviously not. Okay, but wait, for the ones that we're not very sure about, can we just say E for ladies?
Ew.
How'd you think you did?
I mean, I never lose.
Well, looks like you just drew a platypus playing basketball.
I was thinking maybe I could get extra credit if I named it after you.
No, that's not how it works. Thank you. How'd you do?
Okay, there were a lot of A's.
Yeah, but I think that's how it was supposed to be, right? If we fill out A for everything, that means we get an A. Yeah.
Wait. Do you see this flimsy piece of paper they call a Scantron? If you take it like this, and then you start to fold it like that, what does that look like?
Oh my gosh, it looks like a smiley face.
Joy!
Let's turn it in like that.
Okay, yeah. Cool.
I feel pretty confident.
That's good. How'd it go?
Guys, a lot of people turned in their tests before us. I bet none of that was even right.
And there's just still no way we could have done well without the lucky pencil.
I just hope that all that studying that we did with our learning community paid off.
Well, how'd the test go?
I think we filled out the wrong side of the Scantron.
Might have wanted a bit short answer.
Can you get worse than an F in college? I think we got a G.
Well, you see, if it was multiple choice and we guessed on every single one, that means, 25% chance. But that means we got a 25% chance of getting a 25. That's good, right?
It was true or false.
I don't know!
How'd it go?
We honestly crushed it.
It really wasn't that bad. And regardless, at least our Vineyard Gucci Bedazzled Jordans are still lit.
Okay.
So, where did the people go?
Well, the test ended 10 minutes ago, so. Do you have a Scantron for me?
great job on your first semester.
Thanks, I can't believe it went by so fast.
A captain is blessed. That much is apparent just walking around the Great Lawn. When I came to CNU, I had a dream for what I wanted to do with my life. But it was just a dream until I met my academic advisor. After knowing me for only 15 minutes, he used his connections to get me a dream come true internship in a field I want to devote my life to. I've changed a lot since my freshman year, and I know that I have a lot of change still to come over my last 2 years. But one thing I will always know is that a captain is wholly and truly blessed.
Have fun on your break.
Thanks. Ew.
A captain is family. Coming to CNU, I was following in my sister's footsteps. I knew I'd have my best friend. Little did I know, my time here would allow me to develop relationships that will forever shape who I am. Needless to say, CNU is my home. A captain is family.
See you next semester.
A captain is vulnerable. As an individual, it's extremely hard for me to open up to people. Rejection has always been my biggest fear, and that was the biggest deterrent my freshman and sophomore year from becoming involved on campus. But at the start of my junior year, I decided to challenge myself. I joined Greek life, got involved with a club sport, and even got a job on campus. But I couldn't have done these things first without realizing within myself that it's okay to be uncomfortable. It's okay to take risks, because in the end, you'll be better for it. A captain is vulnerable.
Good job on your finals.
A captain breaks barriers. My initial transition into CNU was at first very difficult. The wall I built around myself in high school acted as a comforting and familiar companion on my way to college. It took a while into my first semester to realize that what I thought was protecting me was actually isolating me from my fellow captains. It was at that point that I decided to completely immerse myself into the CNU community, and I made the best decision ever and joined one of the LGBT organizations on campus. It was there that I met one of the coolest people I've ever gotten to know, and I'm honored to share the stage with her today. All it takes is one step outside of your comfort zone, and it'll make all the difference. Captain breaks barriers.
I'm so happy that my residents realize that CNU can really make their dreams come true.
All the things we said might be hard to pronounce.
I think they deserve one more round of applause. All right. So parents, we are going to have to say goodnight to you guys, and we will see you bright and early tomorrow for breakfast at Regattas. Students, we are going to be heading on over to the Freeman Center for evening activities, so we shall see you there. As for you students, please stay seated, and your crew leader will come out to meet you, all right?